Hello everybody, my vlog is continuous. Today I wanted to show you my third workout, squats. Also, I will tell you how I eat. A couple of thoughts about powerlifting and, as always, a little secret from me for good lift. Let's go! So now I have set for myself 1300 calories per day. This is about 1000 calories less than my zero balance. And the week I get about 7000 calories deficiency. It's a lot. But for fat burning effect, this is enough. Of course, at such low calories, training should be very correct, because it's easy to get into overtraining. And my goal is to regain 100% strength and add another 5%. Most powerlifting schools find it impossible to be in a calorie deficit and build strength. But I want to say it's the biggest shit that they give us. I am from the first competition in my career, struggling with excess weight, and my strength has always grown. I will say one fact from my life. It was sometimes when I didn't cut the weight. And these were my unsuccessful lift. I raised 95% of what I can. The power was disappearing somewhere. I'm sure that no one will tell you about this fact. For one reason only. No one has experienced this for so long and regular like me. But now there are already around the world some who think the same way, and it makes me happy. So about squat. I'm starting to stretch legs and at least 15 minutes. I don't use rolls, vibrators and various rubber bands. I treat them well, but I don't use. Why do I emphasize this? Because I want to tell you, if you don't like it or you don't need it, then why should you use it and repeat for everyone? Your body and you better know how to prepare it for training. Just know, there is no such rule to warm up like everyone else. Today, my workout will be only squats. No additional exercise. I am doing 55 pounds 10 reps, 145 8 reps 2 sets, 35 pounds 5 reps, 325 3 reps, and 415 2 reps with wraps.
Yeah. She's got some nice long hair and you know that she's a bad chick. All the boys stare, can't help it, it's a habit. Clothes that she wears, short skirt and a jacket. I just wanna get her all alone on a mattress. I just wanna have it, I just gotta have it. Rumors all around say her body is fantastic. All natural, not a piece of fur is plastic. Head to her toes, yeah, they say that she's a latch. Yeah, the whispers all the...
465, 4 reps. It was not according to plan. The plan was for 5 reps. I had strength, but I began to choke. I ran out of air. I think it was associated with 2 facts. The first is the start of vitamin work. Vitamins give shorts of breath. And the second, I caught a cold. But I found out about this right after the end of the training. I started a fever and now I'm being treated. Usually, I don't get sick at all, and if suddenly a virus, then everything goes away in one day. During my stay in America, it is 2 years, I have never been sick. I'm sure most of you have a question. Why such a little training? Let's take a look. Firstly, I'm very good at all exercise, and when it's used additionally, then it is also correct. But you need to understand, any decision should have a reasonable meaning. If you do this, then ask yourself, why are you doing this? How does it help you become stronger? If we talking about powerlifting, how long do you plan to recover after such a training? Of course, your level of strength should be the main factor when choosing the amount of training. I can tell about myself. My strength level is now so high that even after a light squat, for example, 440 pounds, it's 75%. I have to recover for a very long time, at least 7 days, sometimes 10 days. Imagine my light workout is 3.5 my own weight, and if I make additional exercises, then I will recover in a week, but my strength will not grow. Because growth requires a different recovery factors. This is supercompensation. This factor is important to use not only before the competition. I use it all my training. So, I emphasize, at this stage of my career, I'm doing only one exercise in training and only one workout set. The purpose of this set to do PR. Such hard training, I will have only one per month. And I have to do everything so that in this hard training, I squat more than last. And all that will stop me from doing this I will eliminate it. Now, the plan is changing a bit. This disease and the beginning of my cycle caused me to change my plan. And my second heavy squat will be on the animal cage on March 8th. I said there I would squat 250 kilos, 550 pounds. The question is how many reps? I don't know. By the way, I want to give you a comment and guess how many reps can I do. From 0 to after March 8th, I will choose the one who guesses and send the t-shirt with my brand Absolute Power Unique System. I am afraid of only one thing. Suddenly a person who calls the number 0 will win. Damn you. So, Wednesday, February 12th, I had a deadlift. I started by warming up again 15 minutes. Then 135 pounds at 10 reps. Then I did 225 pounds at 5 reps. Then 3 plates at 3 reps. Next set was 405 pounds for 1 rep.
Remember guys, deadlift, it's not legs, it's not back, it's a head.
Next set was 440 pounds for 1 rep.
So now 200 kilos, 440 pounds, and the head is where the deadlift is burned.
My goal was to make a deadlift with an approximate power reserve of 25 pounds. It felt like it really was. I think the video showed this. The next deadlift will be in a month and it will be necessary to make 465 pounds or 470 with the same power reserve of 25 pounds. Guys, wait for the next video about my bench press, about nutritional supplements, and about how my 1300 calories per day look like. I look forward to hearing from you and waiting for your questions. Love you. Have a good one.